हेलो क्लास 12th स्टूडेंट, टुडे अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3rd. टॉपिक इज लिबरलाइजेशन, प्राइवेटाइजेशन एंड ग्लोबलाइजेशन. दिस इज पार्ट 3rd. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैड टोल्ड यू अबाउट न्यू इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी. ओके, सो वी कम टू नो अबाउट दैट बिकॉज ऑफ द पॉलिसी ऑफ LPQ, बिकॉज ऑफ द पॉलिसी ऑफ LPQ means license protection quota. Because of this policy that is followed by India till 1990, Indian economy become too much worse. Okay, we are having foreign currency only for 2 weeks. After that we cannot do trade. Okay, so our balance of payment is too much unfavorable, foreign exchange reserve only available for less than 2 weeks. Okay, India had caught in debt trap, there is too much inflation. So because of these things, India require $7 billion as a loan. Okay, and for getting this loan, India approached to World Bank and International Monetary Fund. They accepted this much amount as a loan. They ready to grant this much amount as a loan, but there is one condition: you have to adopt LPG, liberalization, privatization and globalization. Okay, there will be no restriction for import of goods and services. There will be no licensing system. Okay, total freedom. That economy that is closed economy, now it is going to be open up for everyone. And in this way, our economy going to be become global. So, in the previous video, we had this much. Okay, so because of getting this much loan, we are not having any other option. We require this much amount to recorrect our condition, inflation, debt trap. We are in debt trap. Okay, to correct unfavorable balance of payment. So we require $7 billion. So because of that, we adopted new economic policy. And this new economic policy means what? We are talking about many reforms that take place. Okay, so it means liberalization, privatization and globalization. So NEP was introduced in July 1991. Okay, and what is the meaning of NEP? It implies number of reforms take place by the government of India to reduce import duty and quota and make economy free economy. Okay, competitive, make the economy competitive economy. Okay, so that was the meaning. What was the objective? Objective is that our economy is going to be global economy. Our producer have to compete with the multinational company, with developed country, and they have to improve their efficiency, their way of production. Okay, so that they are able to meet world class standard. Okay, so that is what in the background. Okay, so what two measures they follow? Stabilizing measures. Okay, and second one is long-term measures. Okay, so we had learned yesterday. Now in this video we are going to discuss about what are industrial sector reform, what are policies adopted by government of India in industrial sector. Okay, so there is a quick revision. Before till the 1990, okay, we are following the policy of LPQ, license permit quota. Okay, so here when we talk about industrial sector before 1991, So we are going to talk about Industrial Policy Resolution 1956. Okay, student? It is related to three-fold classification of industry. Okay, these three-fold classification of industry is related to Schedule A. Within that, there are 17 industry. In Schedule B, there are 12 industry. And in Schedule C, there are left industries. Okay, it is only for government. In Schedule B, government is going to do main leading role and private sector is for doing supplementary role. Okay, student, government is going to play leading role and private sector is only for supplementary role. Okay, now Schedule C, so there whatever left industry, that is for private sector after these 17 and 12 industry. Okay, now for controlling these left industry, there was Industrial Act 1951. Okay, so in Industrial Act 1951, it is related to license system, means written permission. Retain permission, okay, from government, that private sector have to take for what? For set up the industry, for expanding this industry, for diversification. Okay, so all these three steps, if you want to establish a company, you require a written permission. If you want to expand, if before in starting you are producing 100x, now you want to produce 200x, so you have to again take the permission. If you are producing x, now you want to produce y good also, again you have to take permission. So this was the condition of industrial sector till the 1991, before adopting new economic policy. Now what is new in new economic policy? So we are going to start it. Okay, now in order to make necessary reform in industrial sector, the government introduced new industrial policy on July 24, 1991. So underline this line. Okay, now after adopting new economic policy, new industrial policy was adopted or was introduced on July 24, 1991. So this is 1 marks question. And what comes in industrial sector reform? So in industrial sector reform, first point will come reduction in industrial licensing. I had told you now ki there are threefold classification of industry. Okay, in Industrial Policy Resolution, IPR Act 1956. Okay, and whatever industries allotted for the private sector for its controlling, there was an act, that is Industrial Act 1951. Okay, so now that act, Industrial Act 1951, that is related to licensing system. After new adopting new economic policy, there is going to be no Industrial Act 1951. It's mean that ki there is total removal of this act, Industrial Act. Now there is no requirement for getting written permission or getting license for opening, for expanding, for diversification, of a firm. But few industries were still, for that you require written permission. So these are liquor, means alcohol, defense equipment, okay, and industrial explosives. So these, and there are few more. So these are shortlisted industries, still they are under the control of the government. Okay, you have to take permission for opening. Okay, now so in this way, the first step that is taken by the government, okay, under the liberalization, okay, that was reduction in licensing system. Now licensing system is required only related to liquor, defense equipment and industrial explosives. Okay, now you are free to set up new industry to expand or diversify, you don't require any license. Okay, however, license is required for certain industries. So that is written here. Okay, now the second step that is taken under industrial reform under the new economic policy is decrease in role of public sector. So schedule A, I had told you, now schedule A is related to 17 industry that is only run by government. There is only government you can say ki it is allotted for only government. Okay, so now after adopting new economic policy, only three industry: defense equipment, atomic energy generation and railway transportation. Except these three industry, okay, all are free for private sector. Okay, now private sector can open. So 14 industries were now that is open for private. Now private sector can come and establish the industry, they can run it. Okay, only three industries are reserved for government sector out of 17. Okay, so defense, atomic and railway. Still there is only monopoly control of government. Okay, so I think these 2 points clear to you. In industrial sector reform was introduced July 24, 1991, and there are total four steps or four new policies are adopted. The first is reduction in industrial licensing. Only for few industry you require license, otherwise for opening, for expanding, you don't require. Okay, now decrease in only three industries are there for government sector, and 14 are left for private sector. They can open up. Okay, now de-reservation under small scale industry. Okay, when I had explained you industrial sector reform before till the 1950 to 1999, so I had told you about two things. Okay, I had told you about basically two things. First, 1956 IPR, इंडस्ट्रियल पॉलिसी रिजोल्यूशन, इसी के अंदर मैंने आपको एक्सप्लेन किया था इंडस्ट्रियल एक्ट 1951. ओके, सो दिस इज द मेजर थिंग. हियर इज थ्री फोल्ड क्लासिफिकेशन एंड इट इज़ रिलेटेड टू लाइसेंस सिस्टम. ओके स्टूडेंट, आफ्टर दैट आई हैड एक्सप्लेन द मेजर हेडिंग, दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल या मेजर रोल इज गिवेन टू स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री एंड फॉर प्रमोशन, फॉर प्रोटेक्शन and for expansion of small scale industry, many industries were reserved for small scale industry. yani keval agar aap sabun banana chahte ho, aap agarbatti banana chahte ho, to only you can establish small scale industry. and till that how many money you can invest? Only 5 lakh. If you are investing 5 lakh, okay, then you are running a small scale industry. Okay, so now after adopting new economic policy, the first is third step taken by the government is de-reservation under small scale industry. Okay, many I had told you, many industry reserved for only small scale industry. You cannot produce at a large labor. Okay, only you can invest till 5 lakh. Okay, after that you are not allowed. Okay, so now after adopting new economic policy, so under liberalization in industrial reform, many goods produced by the small scale industry have now been de-reserved. That is reserved before 1991. Now there is no reservation. Okay, the investment ceiling on plant and machinery for small scale industry enhanced to ₹1 crore, and this is the second thing that is related to this point. Before that, only 5 lakh investment is allowed under the small scale industry. Okay, after that you cannot invest. Okay, you are running a small scale industry, you can hire, purchase machine equipment till the 5 lakh. Okay, but after new economic policy, फॉर स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री दैट इन्वेस्टमेंट वैल्यू हैज़ बीन इंक्रीज फ्रॉम 5 लाख टू 1 करोड़. ओके नाउ टुडे दिस इज 5 करोड़. इन मेनी इंडस्ट्री द मार्केट वॉज अलाउड टू डिटरमाइन द प्राइज थ्रू द फोर्सेज ऑफ मार्केट. ओके इन बिफोर 1991 या बिफोर द अडॉप्टिंग न्यू इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी द प्राइज ऑफ मेनी प्रोडक्ट इज डिसाइडेड बाई गवर्नमेंट. बट आफ्टर न्यू इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी द प्राइज ऑफ स्मॉल स्केल द प्राइज ऑफ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री वॉज डिसाइडेड बाई मार्केट फोर्स मीन्स मार्केट सप्लाई एंड मार्केट डिमांड वेयर बोथ आर गोइंग टू बी इक्वल सो दैट विल बी मार्केट प्राइस. ओके एंड बिफोर दैट इट इज़ डिसाइडेड बाई द गवर्नमेंट बट आफ्टर अडॉप्टिंग इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी इट इज़ डिसाइडेड बाई मार्केट फोर्स. ओके नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज मोनोपोलीज एंड रिस्ट्रिक्टिव ट्रैप पॉलिसीज. सो इट इज़ नोन एज अ इन शॉर्ट MRTP Act. Monopolies and restrictive trap policies. Okay, with the introduction of this act, now there is no requirement for getting a written permission for expensing. Okay, for requirement of large companies seek prior approval for expansion establishment. Means MRTP Act is related that ki after adopting new economic policy you don't require getting a written permission for expansion or for establishment. If you want to establish a new firm or you want to expand your firm, you don't require any written permission. Okay, means no license, you don't require any license. So this is your MRTP Act. MRTP Act means this is act that give power to private sector to open industry and to expense industry. Okay, you don't require any license. So in this way industrial sector reform have completed. Industrial sector reform introduced in July 24, 1991. There are 4 steps. Reduction in licensing system, only few industries shortlisted. That for only you require written permission. जिसके लिए आपको written permission चाहिए, जैसे liquor defense. Other are left for private sector. Now, only three industries are there for government. Okay, that is governed by government: defense, atomic, railway, and all industries are left for private sector. Dereservation. So now investment criteria has been increased from 5 lakh to 1 crore and there will be no reservation for small scale industry. Iske andar kya hai ki maan lo aapko agarbatti se related industry setup karni hai to pehle aap iska keval small scale industry yani aap keval 5 lakh ka hi investment kar sakte the lekin abhi aap kya hai ki isko large scale pe bhi produce kar sakte ho. Okay, so that is this power is given to private sector in this dereservation. Okay, and monopoly MRTP Act, it is related to that ki now private sector are free, they are having this power, they can open industry anywhere anytime and they can diversify. They don't require any license or written permission. Now financial sector reform. So industrial sector reform has completed. Now financial sector reform. So first of all you need to understand the meaning of financial sector. What is the meaning of financial sector? So financial sector, this is the meaning. Financial sector includes financial institutions. Financial sector means what? Financial institution like commercial bank, investment banks, stock exchange operations, foreign exchange market. So it include actually 4 things: all commercial bank, investment banks, stock exchange operations and foreign exchange market. Okay, so before new economic policy, before adopting new economic policy, the central bank was in the role of कंट्रोलर, वॉज इन द रोल ऑफ कंट्रोलर, बट आफ्टर अडॉप्टिंग न्यू इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी इट बिकम फैसिलिएटर. दिस इज़ द बेसिक क्वेश्चन दैट इज आस्क्ड इन बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन कि आफ्टर अडॉप्टिंग एनएपी हाउ आरबीआई बिकम एज अ फैसिलिएटर इन प्लेस ऑफ कंट्रोलर. ओके, सो बिफोर द 1991 एनी फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन वॉन्ट टू take any decision, they have to contact RBI. They cannot take any decision, minor or major, without the permission of RBI. मतलब हर एक decision को लेने के पहले उन्हें कोई भी steps उठाने से पहले उन्हें RBI की permission लेनी होती थी. तो in this way, before the 1991, RBI was controller. Okay, they are, RBI is going to control financial sector, means all commercial bank, all investment bank, स्टॉक एक्सचेंज मार्केट एंड फॉरेन एक्सचेंज मार्केट. बट आफ्टर अडॉप्टिंग न्यू इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी इट बिकम फैसिलिएटर. ओके, सो नाउ दिस फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन दे डोंट हैव टू कंसर्न एवरी टाइम टू आरबीआई. उन्हें हर बार आरबीआई को कंसर्न नहीं करना होगा. दे कैन टेक मेनी डिसीजंस देमसेल्फ. ओके, so that is here given. So I think you are able to understand the meaning of financial sector. Financial sector means financial institution. Financial institutions are what? Commercial bank, investment bank, stock exchange operation, and foreign exchange market. Okay. Now the reform introduced under financial sector are first the change in role of RBI. The role of RBI was reduced from regulator to facilitator. So before the 1990, RBI was what? RBI was regulator. But after new economic policy, it become facilitator. Means from 1991 till now, it become facilitator. And before that, it was regulator. Okay. As a result, financial sector was allowed to take decision on many matters without consulting RBI. इसका मतलब कि अब उन्हें हर एक decision लेने के लिए okay RBI से concern करना, उनकी permission लेना जरूरी नहीं होता है. ठीक है, they can take many decisions themselves. So in this way now RBI become facilitator in place of regulator. So remember, this is very very important question from my side for your board examination. Okay student, next topic is origin of private banks. Okay, before new economic policy, we don't find any existence of private bank in India. If you talk about banking system, so there is only government bank. There is only government bank. But after accepting new economic policy in July 1991, now private sector is allowed to open and run private banks. Okay, so that is given here. The reform policy led to establishment of private sector banks, Indian as well as foreigner, means anyone that is Indian or that is a foreigner, if he want या शी wants to open a bank, they have to fulfill some criteria, they can open bank and run bank. Okay, for example, so there are given some example of private bank ICICI. Okay, and in foreign bank HSBC. Increased the competition and benefited the consumer through lower interest rate and better system. Okay, so before the before 1991 there is only government bank. Okay, and after 1991, yeah, after adopting the new economic policy, we find many private bank, and because of these private bank, emergence of private bank, there is more competition in financial sector, and whenever there is financial competition, it is going to give benefit to whom? Give to benefit to consumer are able to get many they are able to get loan on low interest rate. Okay,